It's me, Mikey Pipes. Today's Monday. Monday, June 12th, 2023. And I'm here with Man Baby. Look at him. He's a big mother effer right here.
That is true.
That is true. Look, I even got him a 2X custom pipe doctor shirt. Missing his name, though. I don't want to put Man Baby. Oh, actually, I should have put Man Baby on there. Put James.
It's not too late.
Man Baby below it. That would have been pretty epic. It's not too late. You know what? I'll get you the short sleeve joints.
Perfect.
We're here in Long Beach. James, what I call amongst a sea of condensers. There are condensers all over this luxury condominium building rooftop. And we're here for not one, not two, not three, but 10 apartments. I was going to show you clips of one, but just look at this view, ladies and gentlemen. Let me show you. Just take a look at this gorgeous view, ladies and gentlemen. Take a look at the view. She is nice. Nice, nice view. That's the Atlantic Ocean. We're in Long Beach on Long Island in the state of New York in the United States of America. And there is the ocean. Beautiful, beautiful day. Imagine being in your hot tub right here or having a meal, a picnic, a barbecue, overlooking this beautiful God's creation. Amazing. All right, let's go head on in inside. Let's go downstairs to the 8th floor apartment. Let's check out the 2 air conditioning air handlers, the 2 filters. We'll do a visual inspection of the 2 coils, the 2 blower motors, the 2 capacitors, the 2 drain lines, 2 of 2. And then we'll head up back upstairs and do a full PM on these units, including for the first time in this building, because now we have access to water, a full condensing coil wash and rinse. Smash that thumbs up button. Let's go. What do you think? Not too shabby. Not too shabby. Let's take a look at the coil. Let's see what we got here. Let's see what we have here. Well, looking pretty clean. Looking pretty clean. Replacement filter. Make sure the arrow points up. The return air is going in through this open stand, air handler stand, and being brought into the air handler. And there's our supply. So this is what we call an upflow air handling unit. Let's take a look at our blower. Check the capacitor. Ooh, that could have landed on my... That would have landed on my foot. That would have been an OSHA violation. Ouch. Bombas wouldn't save me. Okay, we'll kill power to the unit. Here is our capacitor. Looks fairly new. This is a 20. That's a 20. Let's test
capacitor. 20.4.
She good?
That's system number 2.
Filter. New filter. Airflow points up, ladies and gentlemen. Someone put a door frame right here. Okay, let's check our capacitor.
Not making that mistake again.
All right, there's our capacitor. She's another 20. Let's see how she rates. One terminal, another terminal, and we got 19.5. We good. Should we test if we can hear it?
Up to you.
Does she pass the shake test? Problem is I can't get my quarter wrench in there. Let's try a miniature quarter wrench. Wow. She don't want to get in there. Let's try this. Let's listen. No. No noise. She's good. Here, let's put the cover back on. Let's not make the same mistake
that someone else did. Look at this. I got myself a brand new pair of Bosch Professional needle nose pliers. Wow. Hashtag love Bosch.
A lot of the units have been sitting in the sun for a very long time. So one of the things I like to do is identify them. So I've identified this unit as the apartment 806 going to my living room area. And that's 806, that's going to the bedrooms and the guest area. So now if I'm not the one who's here next time or another guy's here next time, at least since my system is running, we're gonna do something a little different than we normally do, especially since we have the amount of rust and corrosion on my capacitor. We're gonna test this capacitor, which someone conveniently used the band on, so now I can't see it. We're gonna test this capacitor dynamically. What that means, ladies and gentlemen, is that we're gonna test the capacitor while the system is actively running. Power supply, we have a call for cool, compressor, condenser fan motor are all on. My contactor obviously is pulled in, right? And I have a closed circuit on the L1, L2 going to T1, T2. So we're gonna dynamically test this capacitor. And I'm gonna show you a pretty cool tool, an app from HVAC school. Let me show you.
The HVAC school app. I'm gonna open that up. And we have a nice little nifty calculator in here. We're going to tools, we're gonna go under load capacitor test, right? And in case we don't know what goes where, voltage across capacitor, amperage of motor start winding, and capacitor rated MFD, we have a little guide right there, very easy. So the first thing we're gonna do, we're gonna take a measurement between common and herm, right? And we're gonna see what kind of voltage we get.
So my terminal with four terminals on top of it, that's gonna be my common. The one with the three, that's gonna be my herm. And I have 282.6 volts. 282.3. Too many points there. And now we do amperage motor, amperage of motor start winding. Let's figure that out.
Had it on the wrong one.
I have my clamp on 902 FC Fluke HVAC meter on, my brown wire, which is going to my compressor, and I have 7.7. So let's put in 7.7. All right, and we don't know what this capacitor is rated for. We really don't know. All right, so let's see.
What so unfortunately, I had to turn off the power to the unit at the disconnect, but we're reading that 70/5 is what this is rated for. So let's see what the app tells us. So let's do 70, calculate, and the amount of variation is acceptable. So right now we're at 70, we're reading 72.36, and we're within the deviation of this. But there's one other thing I want to show you.
And the one thing I want you to hold it to, right? Yes, testing dynamically is a great way, you know, you don't have to disturb any of the terminals, but will it pass the shake test? No bueno. While the power is off, we're going to remove our wiring from our contactor and we're going to test the coil rating of that capacitor. Of that coil, right? And we're going to take our same multimeter, the 902 FC, right? One side, we're going to make sure it's set to read resistance. We're going to put one on one side of the contactor, one on the other. And we should be in the teens, and we're at 19. Good. All right, now that we replaced both of our dual capacitors, one there, there's the other. We took both condenser fan motor tops off. Unfortunately, this one broke a little bit, so we'll wrap it up with some electric tape. No harm really there. I don't have that much strain on these wires on both of them, so we're good there. Man baby is now, we're pre-rinsing or soaking the coil, the condensing coil. Again, to my knowledge, we've never, ever, ever, keeping it real, we've never, out of all the units that we service here, with the exception of those two, and I'm keeping it real, I lost a customer. Let me show you. I lost a customer to these people. See, there's all hours energy underneath this sticker. That's my yellow sticker. That's me, pipe doctor, see? I lost a customer. And 406R. Wow. I put these in, but I lost a customer. It is what it is, ladies and gentlemen. It is what it is. You know, you got to take it on the chin. Take it on the chin. So we're pre-rinsing both condensers, and then we're going to use the Viper Venom Pack on these two Colemans. Coleman, yep, they make great camping equipment. Look, there's the lantern. There's the gas lantern, ladies and gentlemen. Coleman, I don't know. Stick to camping equipment, guys. Stick to camping equipment. All right, so I did this condenser, and I paid a lot of attention to the outside of the condensing coil as well, especially because right on top of the roof, but most importantly, right on top of the ocean right there, all that salt in the air. Now I have Man Baby soaking down the coil with the Viper Venom Pack. He's getting the nozzle as close to the coil as possible. That way we get maximum penetration through the condensing coil, getting as much of the chemical into the coil as possible. And you could see any progress made there. You see a little bit of bubbles there. It's kind of hard to get all the way through there, but when the closer you get to the coil, the faster it comes out. There it is. So we're going to saturate from the inside out. And then, like I said, we're going to do the outside of the coil as well to get that good rinse and get all the salt off the air. All right. So now we are rinsing. We're not rinsing. We're applying the Venom Pack by Refrigeration Technologies. Don't play with the bubbles. Let's go. Come on. What, you want to blow bubbles next? You want to blow bubbles? Man, babe, you want to blow bubbles? There you go. Get it all on there. Good stuff. Watch the electric, James. Okay, we're going to finish the whatever remaining is in there. And then we're gonna let this sit for a little bit and then rinse. What's the matter, Man Baby? I'm watching James trying to resecure. Oh, he's gonna lose all those screws on the floor now. Watch. They're all gonna go on the floor. I'm watching him struggle with this. See? Let's give him a hand. Oh, there goes one. He lost one. Well, you put it on the top of a condenser that I knew was going to vibrate away as soon as your impact driver was a thing. It's on the floor somewhere. Yeah. James, you know that it's like magnetic, right? Abba never showed you how to use a screw gun when... Aw, I failed at the Abba. Aw. You gotta wear some bling too. How come you don't got it? Oh, you do got some bling on. Oh, yeah. You know, we're probably gonna have... It's probably a good idea if you actually leave the bling at home. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because...
Well, I don't know what you said.
It's probably a good idea for you to leave the bling at home.
Why?
Because, you know, walking around electricity. So you're not... You're Your screw gun needs to be one with the screw. If the screw gun is on an angle, on a different angle than the actual screw is in, it's not going to work. There should be nothing to move around. You're not going to be... Listen, you have all of these other security... Listen, you got to be one. You got to be one with the screw hole, and the screw gun. Let me show you. Look. Okay, look. Right? There you go. There's your little hole right there, right? Look. So my angle of attack is there. See that angle of attack? Here, look, here's another one, right?
Yeah.
Right? That one's all the way over there. Find the screw. You lost the screw. You lost the screw. I don't know. Good luck. It's there somewhere. Oh, poor Man Baby. Oh, you found the screw? And no, we didn't steal that from another one. So let's see if you can apply the principle I just showed you to get the screw into that screw hole. The screw hole is off center. So let's see. See,
You're not maintaining the angle of attack on all three, items. The screw hole, right? The screw and the bit.
How does that look?
Okay, but you're not keep maintaining that.
Why am I not maintaining
it? I don't know, because it's, you don't know. Yachad? Well, because now you have in reverse. See? What are you doing? Yeah, practice makes perfect. You ready for the next part? We're gonna test amperage, okay? We're gonna test
amperage. Get what on the bottom?
Yeah, it's fine. Let's go to put our voltmeter to read clamp on ampery, amperacy, right? And we're gonna plug in our disconnect, and we're gonna see what that jumps to when we first turn it on. Those cold compressor starts, right? Let's see what happens. So make sure everything is dry. You're gonna hold that. I'm gonna plug in. Be a good cameraman. Focus on that. Here we go. We have an issue. Our condenser fan motor is hitting that. Looks like I effed up a little bit. All right, that's secure now. Wish it looked better. All right, I'm gonna plug this in. Wow, that's bad. Only stopped at around 10 and a half. Pretty good, huh? Oh, what just happened there? What just happened there? Something happened. Was that a call for heat was over? Or did something short out? Let's see, we have voltage here. I have voltage there. I have voltage there. And together, I have... Look at that, together I have nothing. Huh. Something just freaky happened. Something freakishly just happened here. There's a voltmeter, right? So between L1... and there, I have 122 volts. See that? And between there and there, also have 122 volts. And together, I have nothing. Let's see if my contact is still closed. I have there. I have there. Huh. You know what? Let's go to the disconnect. Let's pull that out. Let's check here. Come on. Be a good camera guy. All right, here's where our line power coming in. So there to there, I got how many volts? How many volts do I have, James? The voltmeter.
123.
Okay, there you go. And here is my other side, there to there, how many volts do I have?
121.
All right, let's do them together. How many volts do I have? Ooh, I have 213. So what happened between there and there? Was my disconnect not all the way insecure? Let's see what happens. Ooh, look at that, our disconnect is not going back in the way it should. Interesting. Now it clipped in. Look at that. Pretty freaky stuff there, huh?
Smart.
Yep, very smart. All right, so we had a little side distraction. I was ready to put the voltmeter away, but I never checked amperage on the other side. So there I have 12, right? 12. Okay, so we're good there. Let's check our fan. Our fan's this big one right there. 0.5 from the capacitor. I'm quite confident. Let's check this red one. That's 0.8. That's going to go probably going to my fan, 0.1. Let's see what this one is. That one's 7.9. That's definitely going to my compressor. Let's check out this one. 1.2. That's going to my condenser fan motor. I'm good with those numbers. If I had a fan motor that was reading, you know, like over that into the threes, you know, that's reason to be concerned that fan motor is going to be dying soon. And one thing that I did notice, and we lifted up both condenser fan motors, so a lot of rust there. There's a little bit of oil residue. So probably with next season, we're going to recommend that to be changed. We'll make them aware of that today when we go back downstairs. Let's just button up, head up to the next. Smash that thumbs up button and subscribe. Thanks so much for watching. Be well, God bless, stay safe.